But while I've got you tonight, we've often spoken to you about Middle Eastern issues because everyone knows you're a former Australian ambassador to Israel, but you also served as a diplomat in Washington. So you know how the American system operates. You must be watching this election contest with an enormous amount of interest. Do you believe, you know, the polls have got it right, that it's going to go right down to the wire and it's too difficult to choose who's going to win?
I'm really not sure what to believe, Chris. I mean, the polls have obviously been wrong on a, you know, number of major geopolitical events, Brexit, the 2016 election, even the 2020 election, where the polls vastly overstated Joe Biden's level of support and that ended up being a close result. So I'm watching with a high degree of interest, but I think there's a lot of inbuilt errors into polling methodology, a lot of vagaries in the American political system that we don't necessarily need to account for here in Australia.
Yep.
Foremost amongst them being optional voting rather than compulsory voting. And it's quite hard to sort of determine, you know, how all those things will shake out. So
sure is.
It's certainly a dramatic race.
One person will be
I don't know what the result will be.
Yeah, one person will be watching with a great amount of anxiety, I would think, is our current ambassador to the US, former Prime Minister Kevin Rudd. Do you believe his position will be untenable if Donald Trump returns to the White House?
Look, ultimately, that will be, obviously, and this is self-evident, of course, a question for the government of the day. I know he has been doing work to rebuild relations with the Trump administration, but by the same token, he's been on the public record in a way I don't think any other ambassador has been, being highly personally critical of Trump. Now, it doesn't need to be an insuperable obstacle, but it's certainly a relevant consideration. And, you know, it's the government's role to make sure we've got the best ambassador in place who can work as closely as possible with whatever administration, Democrat or Republican.
And the best ambassador to advance Australia's interests can't be one who's on the record flagrantly attacking Donald Trump. Fascinating stuff. Thanks for joining us, Dave. I appreciate it. Dave Sharma there, Liberal Senator for New South Wales, joining us live from Canberra.